I recently completed my professional experience at Epping Boys High School. My aim for this professional experience was to branch out and experiment with some different styles of teaching other than lecturing. The teaching episode which I will be discussing was Period 1 on Monday the 25th of November. I had Year 9 Food Technology Theory and I decided to experiment with the more student-centered approach by implementing subgroup work over 4 stations in the classroom. Throughout the lesson, the students were disengaged with the work, constantly talking and not completing the work altogether. Rather than assisting the students with the work and the content, I found myself spending the whole lesson just managing their behaviour, and by the end of the lesson, I felt that I'd lost all control and my ACU supervisor had to step in. Group work is an effective teaching strategy that promotes academic achievement if it is managed correctly. Group work is a student-centered approach where students take control of their learning rather than just receiving knowledge from the teacher. Although student-centered approaches allow the student to develop greater skills in problem-solving, critical thinking, and time management, it takes some of the authority away from the teacher, hence it must be set up correctly to be productive. This is supported by Giles and Boyle in their research on group work, where they state that a reason for the decreased use of group work in the classroom is it can create situations that are difficult for teachers to manage and control. In my situation, the group work with Year 9 created a classroom environment which, as a pre-service teacher, I didn't have the skills or the knowledge to manage. Giles and Boyle also state in their research on group work is that teachers avoid using the pedagogy as they lack the knowledge on how to manage group work and set it up to be productive. I completed some research on how to set up group work and came across the social interdependence theory by Kurt Kofter. Social interdependence theory is a theoretical framework which outlines 5 variables which, when followed, result in cooperation among individuals. The 5 variables include: firstly, positive interdependence, which is individuals believe they can reach their goals if the people they are working with have the same attitude. The second variable is individual accountability, which is individuals' responsibility to complete their share of the work to contribute to the whole. The third variable is promotive interactions, which includes individuals motivating each other through sharing varying viewpoints and ideas. The fourth variable is social skills, which is the way individuals communicate amongst each other and support each other. And the final variable is processing and reflecting, which is individuals encouraging each other to set goals, then provide feedback. If each of these variables from the social interdependence theory are taken into consideration when implementing group work in the classroom, it is a step towards creating a productive environment where students work effectively together. My ACU supervisor was observing the lesson where the group work didn't go according to plan. Feedback I received from my supervisor from that lesson directly links to many of the variables from the social interdependence theory. Some of the feedback I received included: move or separate students that cannot work together. This feedback links to the first variable of positive interdependence, as when students cannot work together, they will bring each other's achievements down. Another piece of feedback was to get students to allocate parts of the task to each other so that every student in the group is accountable. This feedback can be linked to variable number 2, which is individual accountability. Upon reflection, I believe this is a very important piece of feedback, as I noticed when monitoring the group work, the same students were always doing the work, and other students would just copy or not contribute. This created tension within the groups, which contributed to the off-task behaviour and in the end, the students not completing the work altogether. Finally, in the future, organise the groups ahead of the lesson and don't allow the students to choose their own groups. This feedback links to variable number 3, which is promotive interactions. This feedback links to variable number 3, as in my situation with Year 9, I allowed the students to select their own groups. The group work got out of hand as the students partnered up with their friends, hence they were off task and not motivating each other through on task positive interaction. So to conclude, in future professional experiences and when I begin teaching myself, some group work practices I will focus on to ensure I set it up to be productive include that I set up the groups ahead of the lesson to ensure that the students won't get off task by working with their friends. I will also break down the task into smaller parts, which the students can allocate to ensure the work is evenly distributed. Also, by making the students accountable for a certain part of the task, it will motivate them to complete the work. Despite my group work task not going well, I feel that I have benefited. I am excited to put these practices to the test and work on my skills in managing group work, as I do believe it is a beneficial pedagogy to use in the classroom.